Hi everyone, how are you? I am sitting with my cute little cat curled up on my lap and I am ready to talk to you about some painting stuff. In today's video, I wanted to talk about 5 tips because you know me, I do my 5 tip videos, but 5 tips on knowing what to paint, and I'm hoping that this is useful, maybe something that you haven't really thought about before, but these are things that I have been learning myself recently in the past couple weeks. So there's that. Before we begin, I would like to say thank you so much to Yellow Images for sponsoring this video. Yellow Images is the number one marketplace of high quality premium mockups, creative fonts, images 360 degrees, and a creative store full of amazing graphic assets like brushes, presets, lettering, illustration, patterns, textures, UX and UI kits, and more. With their Yellow Ticket, you can make a high quality project for almost 10 times cheaper than before. An average asset will only cost you around $150. You can get 3 free items every month and a 30% discount for custom mockup services, and you can buy anything from the creative store twice cheaper with Yellow Ticket, get instant synchronization of your Dropbox and Yellow Images account, and it saves you time and money. For today's video, I wanted to create a tiny little mock-up. Actually, it's not tiny, it's really cute, of a fake yogurt brand that I made called Thimble & Co. Just because Thimble's a cute word, I was like, okay, I'm gonna make up a small little brand and just use assets from Yellow Images. So the fonts, except for Future Condensed for the weight of the item, the fonts, the images, and the mockups are all from Yellow Images. And as you can see right here at the end, using my Yellow Ticket, I saved $40. So the object mockups and the PNG images were heavily reduced, I think like 90%, and then the creative store was half off. So if you're even looking for anything like fonts, it's such a great place to look for them because you can get them at such a discounted rate. I opened up the mockup in Photoshop to just see what the canvas size looked like and made this entire little brand in Illustrator. It's kind of very simple, easy, modern design nowadays, but I just wanted to show you how easy it is to make your own design this way and to present it really professionally. I think that the mockup seals everything in by making it look so believable and it's like something that you would see in an advertisement. I love the huge high-risk PNG image of the blueberries. I think this like final little promotional image for the mockup looks so cute. You can follow the link in the description and use my code Sarah30 to get a 30% off of a 3-month or annual premium membership Yellow Ticket and an annual team membership Yellow Ticket. So this coupon is limited and valid for 1 month only starting today. It's going to be down in the description. Let me know if you create anything cool with these assets, but I hope you enjoy this. I mean, honestly, like this tiny little design segment, because I'm a designer, I'm a graphic designer, so it's interesting to like use my graphic design here on my illustration YouTube. Okay, let's get into the topic of this video. So these are things that I really have been thinking about myself in the past few weeks, so I really wanted to share them with you because I hadn't thought about them in quite this angle before. The first one is to look at content that people like to consume. I like to create content specifically for Instagram, and I create digital paintings and show the process on my YouTube, but when I'm thinking about the paintings I want to create, I'm like, what painting am I going to make for Instagram? I also think about what I would like to create as a print, what I would like to hang on my wall. And when I'm looking at the content that people like to consume on Instagram, this includes influencers' posts, like their actual photos and their poses, makeup that's been popular, even TikTok showing different styles, different poses, aesthetics. And while all of this is trendy and something that I have stayed away from, I've recently realized I can incorporate kind of trendy aspects into my own artwork and still have my artwork be genuine and authentic and my style. Like, it doesn't have to be you selling your soul by doing something that's trendy. You can make it your own and make it something that other people enjoy. And something that I've realized is that I've been staying away from things that are popular, but they're popular for a reason. I've always been the kind of person to not listen to a band or watch a movie because it was so popular and I was like, I'm not like everybody else. Like, I don't need to watch this really popular movie. For example, I'm not a big rom-com person and I didn't watch Crazy Rich Asians because I was like, I'm not going to enjoy this. Everybody loves it. They're for sure, it's just, it's gonna be cheesy, it's not gonna be good. I watched it and I loved it. And I was like, dude, there's a reason why this is popular. People love it because it's so good. So I've been learning to like embrace things that are popular and try to see how do I incorporate them into my own style. I will be honest, I do not go on TikTok like ever. If I ever watch TikToks, there are YouTube compilations of like art TikToks or makeup or nail TikToks, or hair specifically. I love hair ones, but I'm never scrolling on the actual app. I'm so aware of what a time waster it is, and I don't actually use the app. My second tip is to find color palettes as inspiration. This is very simple. I think maybe one of the things that's more obvious and one of the things that you've already been doing, but I've personally been looking at design palettes and thinking, how am I going to incorporate this into my own art? So I've been much more conscious of what colors I'm using and how they affect the mood of the piece. Well, I was doing that before, but it was more of a trial experimentation kind of thing, and I wasn't looking at color palettes online. So for example, for this painting, the colors I'm using are all like a very cohesive soft pastel palette with that blue included. Looking at color palettes, if you're not really good with knowing what colors go together, knowing color theory, it can really help you get a sense of complementary colors and what colors really work together to create a cohesive piece. So Pinterest is going to be such a good resource for you. Again, going to Pinterest to get a lot of inspiration and not to specifically copy, but I think if somebody makes a color palette for you to use, you are very welcome to use it for your artwork. My third tip is something that I have been doing most out of all of this stuff, is going out in nature and meditating. So I have been really enjoying the springtime. My seasonal depression is fading and it is real. I have insane seasonal depression. I think it's hit everybody really hard this year, but I mean, speaking from personal experience, I was doing pretty badly. So I found myself, as the seasons have been changing and as spring has come, that I have really been uplifted a lot more so with the weather. I've been outside gardening and I've been taking walks in the park and just enjoying nature a lot more, enjoying the cherry blossoms, and that is what inspired this painting, is all the cherry blossoms. And with Easter just having come and gone, I was really focusing a lot on the concept of rebirth and just my place in this world and in nature and how I interact with the environment around me. And I have been really reflecting on a lot of these kind of deeper issues, which has guided me into figuring out what I would like to paint that comes from the heart. All of this is so cheesy, but something that I've really been thinking about recently. So I do think nature is good. I think nature helps a lot with everything. Just seeing the beauty and glory in nature is so useful in putting ourselves in perspective. And I was just listening to a talk recently about how we are better positive people when we do have a purpose. Like our actions are better. We focus on being good people and being more selfless when we do put ourselves in perspective and have a purpose. And I think that nature and meditating on that really does help put us in a proper perspective. That's way more like esoteric than I ever go on my channel. Take it how you will, but I would definitely recommend taking a walk now and then outside in nature, especially if you are battling some depression right now. It's been helping me. I've been just doing some yard work. Every time I feel a little bit of anxiety, I go and like shovel my dirt outside in my garden. I'm like, okay, let's do this. All that to say, it can really help you figure out what you would like to paint. When you kind of focus on what is important to you, it can make you get back on track with the things that you do want to be portraying in your art. And that's something that I've been learning. I kind of lost sight of all of that for a while and was only painting because it is my job. This is just what I do for a living. And usually when I am not burnt out, when I'm getting enough sleep and have enough time to process and get my creativity out, but also have time to let it rest, I can create my best work. However, I have been in school for such a long time now, and I keep talking about it, but it is true, it's really burnt me out. I am in school for just a creative major, and so everything I create for school, internships, part-time student jobs has been creative. And so when I come to my own art, I've been so burnt out in knowing what I want to create, and so I just paint something for a video or for an educational purpose or just for Instagram, but taking a small break and not painting, letting my back and neck rest as well, and meditating on all of these things has really helped me focus on what I would like my artwork to look like. I talk a little bit more about this on my last Patreon post if you want to go check it out, but I really do enjoy this final painting. I think it captures the mood of this spring for me and kind of this feeling of rebirth. With all this thinking about where I want my artwork to go, I definitely know I would like to paint more intricate scenes and starting to include backgrounds. And so for this painting, I painted this like very blurry, like cherry blossom background. So this is like my tiny little step into getting more involved in painting backgrounds. It's not much, but I am proud of it. So congratulations to me. My fourth tip is to think about a new technique that you would like to try. Oh, that was just what I was talking about, the backgrounds. I wanted to paint the background for this painting, but think about if you would like to practice painting glow your skin or being better at painting hair, painting full bodies or scenes, lighting, all of that good stuff. Think about something that you would like to improve on and see how you can make that the focal point of your next piece. So this might mean that the final painting or piece that you create is not going to be something super aesthetic or polished, but if it's something that helps you improve in your skills and can help you grow in a certain aspect, then that is something you know you want to paint, you know you want to get better at. So I would recommend focusing on that in this painting. I did backgrounds. I understand it's not a like proper background, but I am just dipping my toes in and I will be further venturing into this world. So my next videos for sure will include more complex scenes and bigger paintings, more intricate backgrounds, all that good stuff. Environments. Lastly, I would suggest specifically analyzing what draws you to another creator's work and to see if you can incorporate it into your own style and art. So this does not mean copying somebody's entire style. The reason that you don't want to do that is not even that you're copying a large creator and you're stealing from them, but the fact that that doesn't represent your own body of work and your voice and message. You want to be able to have your own distinct impression on the art community or the world or your just circle. So, you know, copying another artist is not going to benefit you in the long run just because it is not your own voice or your own message. So I don't recommend straight up copying somebody's style, but if you see something that an artist does that you're just so inspired by, the way they treat colors or faces, hair, details, even their editing style or their subject matter. If it's something that inspires you and you just feel so drawn to, maybe it's because it's something that you would like to emulate in your own art. Being able to see what you like from different creators and drawing from their work, incorporating it into your work, is something that can really help you improve. For example, one way that I did that was I never added Lightroom filters or like lens flares or effects or grain on top of my paintings until like a couple of months ago, I don't know. But I never added that because I thought it was cheating. It's not cheating because it's my own work. It's my work is whatever I want it to be. At first I was like, I'm not gonna use the Lightroom effects on my paintings. And I realized, you know what? It's like basically the same thing as curves. I already use curves and it really makes my paintings pop. It makes them look so great. I add a Lightroom effect, some grain, some dust and scratches to the image, some smart sharpen, and it makes the image look so crisp and clean. I just love it. I recommend that you do it if you want to. I can definitely make a video on that in the future. So stay tuned, maybe this summer. I can definitely talk about that, how I edit my paintings. But if you think that your artwork is lacking in a specific way, something that could make it pop, you can definitely look at other creators for inspiration and see what you're doing differently from them. Maybe it will just give you a new perspective on your own artwork. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate you being here and I hope that you enjoyed this video and that it was helpful, that you enjoyed this painting. I love the colors that I used in this piece and I'm really happy that from a kind of a small break from digital portraits like this, I was able to come back and really have fun with the painting and create something that I'm proud of. Like, of course, there's things that are not perfect about this piece and I definitely didn't use any reference, so it's a bit wonky, but in the end, I think that it captured the emotion I wanted perfectly, and I'm really proud of this piece. So let me know if you create something based on these tips that you're really proud of, or just let me know how your art journey has been going since you've been taking it seriously, since you've been improving or practicing. I would really like to know. I read all of your comments and I'm very grateful for the community that I have. I don't know why this whole video is like so sappy. I've just been in a much more, I've been happier. Maybe you can tell by the things that I'm saying, but I've just taken a little bit of a break from painting and from drawing, given my back and my wrist arrest, as I said. I'm happy to come back like refreshed creatively. So maybe that's something you need to do as well. If you are feeling burnt out, just go for it. Thank you for watching. If you enjoy this video, give me a thumbs up and subscribe for more content. I also have, as I said, Instagram and Patreon. If you'd like to follow me on either platform, I would appreciate that. But for now, I'd like to say thank you so much to Yellow Images for sponsoring this video. And if you'd like to grab a yellow ticket to save like almost 10 times the same amount of money to get discounts on custom mockups and to get a discount on the creative store, you can check out the link in the description for 30% off a 3-month or annual premium membership yellow ticket and annual team membership yellow ticket. So it's gonna be down in the description. All my links will be down in the description. I will talk to you guys in my next video. Bye.